Up deep is Andre Hastings and Chad Wilson for the Georgia Bulldogs. Hemp Green will kick it off for Alabama.
Last year's Georgia win has been a rallying cry this week for Alabama.
We're set for the kick.
Rocket.
It's Hastings at the 12. And he's brought down at the 25-yard line. That's where Greg Talley will take the offense. Talley is sacked back to the 21. Steve Webb, a 6-foot-pound senior, on the stop. So it's three and out. Scott Armstrong comes on to punt for Georgia. David Palmer is back. He lets it bounce at the 45, and it's down by Georgia at the 43. It is third and five for the Tide. Let's make that third and eight. Stacy,
look out.
He's got some room. And he'll have a first down. Second and nine. Stacy again. And he gets down to the 35-yard line this time. Third with five to go. Woodson throws complete.
Georgia's got the ball.
Georgia has the ball. Kevin Turner caught the pass, but fumbled the ball. Greg Talley, the quarterback for the Bulldogs. Second and 11. Passes complete, just short of the first down marker, to Arthur Marshall. Third down and one. Harvey and Hurst are the backs in the eye. Strong in motion. Hurst with a lot of room for the first down. Second and 11. There's a fumble. And Alabama comes up with it.
And that's the result.
First and 10. The backs are in the eye. The toss to Stacy. Bowles is way over the 35 inside, close to the 34-yard line. Beginning at 12 noon Eastern time, the number one ranked Florida State Seminoles take on the Michigan Wolverines, and then later on, you'll see a host of games, including Georgia Tech and Clemson. Back to the action. Kevin Turner breaks it all the way inside to the 11-yard line of Georgia. Matt Wethington will come in to kick for Alabama. This is his first field goal attempt of the season. Gene Stallings knows nothing about how he will kick in game situation.
His first as an Alabama Rolling Tide.
32-yard attempt. It's blocked. And no good. Somebody got a piece of that. Scott Armstrong will punt it for the Bulldogs. And Mr. Excitement for Alabama, David Palmer, the freshman, will be back. They want to get him the ball. And he'll let it bounce. And it gets a favorable Georgia bounce all the way down to the 33-yard line. A 50-yard punt, including the roll. We'll be back with more. We have 34 seconds to play in the first quarter. This is Stacy. Actually, Derek Lassick into the ball game now, the tailback, and he takes it over up to the 37. Third and six for the Tide. Oh, Woodson complete over the middle to the 45-yard line. Derek Lassick with a tremendous concentration shot to hang on to the ball. Backs are in the eye. This one goes to Turner. Makes a nice cut and gets close to the 40, about the 43. Second and nine. Woodson completes it to Stacy. And he's down close to the 35. Alabama moving the ball. It's third and three. looks and rolls. And he's caught from behind by number 42, Dwayne Simmons. Simmons has been everywhere on the field tonight. Tank Williamson comes in to punt for Alabama. He'll try and pooch this one inside the 10. And he gets a fantastic bounce. They down it at the 3. A 38-yard punt. But there's a flag on the play. And Zaire will be very close to the first down. It depends on the spot. Second and 10. Larry Weir. Great balance. And look at those penalties.
It's the best drive of the night for Georgia.
And Eric Zaire's leading it. Strong and Weir are the backs. Completes the pass to number 12, Arthur Marshall. It's 3rd and 1. Weir. He'll have the first down and almost broke away for more. Georgia holding on to the ball for over 6 minutes. Zaire sacked by Antonio London. Billy Hallman, it's 3rd and 15 for Alabama. Complete over the middle. Woodson really rifled it in there for Kevin Lee. But a speed, 1st and 10 for Alabama. The reverse to Lee. And he's got some room. He's got one man to beat. Kevin Lee takes it down to the 17-yard line. A 48-yard gain. Chris Wilson made the stop. Just one of two defenders left for Georgia before the touchdown.
They're going to call this against Saran Stacy, I believe. See if there's not a late clip. They'll mark this off against Alabama.
A senior as well. 1st and 10. Woodson is sacked back at the 50-yard line. Nothing giddy about this game so far. 2nd and 22 for Alabama. Woodson completes the pass of the 28 to Saran Stacy. Great mobility by Danny Woodson. 21 yards in the play. 3rd and 1. Stacy will be close to that first down. Wethington misses it. He goes 0 for 2. And this half will end with zeros on the scoreboard. So into punt is Tank Williamson. Back deep, Chuck Carswell. Carswell has run one back already this year in the first game of the season against Western Carolina. That one going for 71 yards. And he'll get a crack at this one. A low driving kick. He gets it at the 48. And Carswell loses a few yards on the return. 2nd and 8. Zaire in trouble, dumps it off to Shannon Mitchell. 2nd and 6. Zaire hits Frank Harvey. Rolls out nicely to complete the pass. Zaire completes it to Larry Weir. Weir deep inside Alabama territory to the 8-yard line. Play action. There's a fumble. And Alabama has the ball.
He can't advance it. He can't advance it. Bring it back.
John Copeland and Steve Webb made the stop and the sack on Eric Zeier.
Don't take that sack down low like that. Either throw it away, or if you are going to get sacked, tuck it away.
Kevin Turner. Tough running, close to the first down. The backs are in the eye. Stacy is the deep back. He gets the toss. And I don't think he made the first down.
No, he should have enough for the first. Should have enough. His forward progress, I think, Mark, took him up near the 30. That should be enough. It is.
He did get it. Third and four. Wilson, incomplete.
Almost made that catch. Tried to scoop it and get his hands under it.
So Cool Pete could make it. Chuck Carswell takes the punt. And he busts it up the middle. Carswell takes it down to the 41-yard line. A 40-yard punt and a 35-yard return. Second and seven. Hand off to Hurst. He's got some room. Garrison Hurst with a nice run over the right side. Garrison Hurst. He'll be short of the first down. And Ray Goff does not even hesitate. He sends in Todd Peterson to attempt the field goal.
Yeah, see, here's a major difference. Ray Goff knows he's got a guy that can bang it through.
And of course, last year, this game was decided on a last-second field goal.
Peterson's only 3 for 7, though. He struggled, but he's got a pretty good leg.
This one will come from 24 yards out.
Do you believe this?
No, I don't. He missed. Georgia turned away again. Second and seven for Denny Woodson in Alabama. Tip but complete to Prince Wembley. It's third and one. Wembley's out wide. Stacy with the first down. Saran Stacy is the deep back. Woodson looking for a receiver. He's coming off an elbow injury last week against Florida. And David Palmer makes the reception at the 35. First and 10. Stacy cuts back. Saran Stacy takes it down to the 15 before being brought down by Mike Jones. 19 yards on the carry. The longest run of the day for Saran Stacy. First and 10 from the 16. What a juke. The ball is just inside the five. First and goal. Stacy, he'll score. Yardage. Alabama moving it in the air. Bit of a surprise, Tim.
Well, it is. I mean, all this talk about Georgia's new offense, Gene Sauling says, hey, it's the same old stuff, very basic.
Third and 12. Little movement on the right side. Zeier is sacked by Eric Curry.
You know what makes this special for Eric Curry? He's from Thomasville, Georgia. He was the Georgia Player of the Year, but went to Alabama. He went to school with a lot of these guys he's playing against.
Scott Armstrong kicking it away. David Palmer lets it bounce. And Georgia gets a good bounce on it. Down to the 33. First and 10 for Alabama, 33. Here's Palmer on the reverse. And Stacy keeps it. Saran Stacy had me fooled.
With his knee.
Yep.
Working on his knee.
Arduously did it all last year. Second and 10. The referee rules it complete over the middle to Curtis Brown.
Watch this. Ball's gone right there on the ground. And yet he's pretty smart for a freshman. That's a great act.
Oh, boy.
And now they're going to take a penalty and then march Georgia even deeper.
Stacy again. Puts his head down and crosses the 10. Stacy again. Down to the 6.
You're going
to
get another flag here for Georgia if they don't watch out.
He was running to the fence.
They got a little bit more than a yard to go, but instead of going after it, they're going to kick the field goal.
Hemp Green from 18 yards out. No doubt.
In whose mind?
So they increased the lead to 10-0. The tied lead.
Hemp Green will kick it off.
Be a little short. Lands at the 12. That's Wilson. Third and 4. And Zaire fumbles it. Georgia recovers the ball. Second and 12. Anderson. Third and 5. Tight end lines up to the left. Robert Turner. Stopped by Dwayne Simmons, but he pulled his way close to the 34, short of the first down. Third and 8. A crucial series for the Georgia. Lobbed up and incomplete. I'm not sure Eric Zaire knew who he was throwing to. Second and 7. Martin Houston, a load at 235 pounds, runs for the first down, 20 yards. 235, and he used every pound. First and 10. This is Lynch. And Woodson's done a credible job on offense tonight. It's 3rd and 7. You jinxed him. Didn't fool anyone on that play. That makes it 4th and 10.
Zaire can't wait to get in the shower right now.
Three receivers out to the left for Georgia. But they won't even catch the ball. Eric Curry living in the backfield. Living large. That'll be the last play of the ball game. Danny Woodson kneels down. Well, I'm not sure that Red Goff thought that his team was going to be shut out, but that's the way it ends. 10-0. Gene Stallings getting from his team what he wanted. He wanted a quarterback that would not get themselves beat. Danny Woodson doing just that.